And in the quiet of the evening, the people of Britain and the Commonwealth heard a voice they knew, that of Sir Winston Churchill, as he introduced Her Majesty the Queen.
We have had a day which the oldest are proud to have lived to see, and which the youngest will remember all their lives. It is my duty and my honor to lead you to its culmination. The splendors of this 2nd of June glow in our minds. Now, as night falls, you will hear the voice of our sovereign herself, crowned in our history and enthroned forever in our hearts. Let it not be thought that the age of chivalry belongs to the past. Here at the summit of our worldwide community is a lady whom we respect because she is our queen, and whom we love because she is herself. Gracious and noble are words familiar to us all in courtly phrasing. Tonight they have a new ring in them because we know they are true about the gleaming figure whom Providence has brought to us, and brought to us in times where the present is hard and the future veiled. It is our dearest hope that the Queen will be happy, and our resolve unswerving that her reign shall be as glorious as her devoted subjects can help her to make it. We pray to have rulers who serve, to have nations who comfort each other, and for peoples to thrive and prosper free from fear. May God grant us these blessings. The Queen.